That's a great. Yeah,
I like that question.
So the question is, if we were in a big box gym and we got handed the keys to the company, what are the things that we would implement? Or if we ran gyms, what would be the things that we would implement? People over everything.
Yeah. Culture, man.
Culture is everything in a gym. So I would walk into a gym, and they put me in some big clubs that were old and broken down. And within a couple weeks, 20-30% increases in revenue. And it was because of the culture. The culture changed in the staff, in the gym. I can walk into a gym and within 5 minutes tell if it's successful or not. And it has nothing to do with the equipment, has nothing to do with the way the gym looks. It's all about the front desk staff and the trainers and how the people are interacting. It's all about the culture.
It's tough to do that, too, because trainers, for the most part, a lot of us are very insecure and or pretentious. And so if that's...
Jeez, thanks.
So if you've got... if you have that in your club, you've got, let's say, 10 trainers that are working in this facility, and, you know, more than half of them are insecure themselves, and they act that way, and you have a new member who comes in, and they'll feel that vibe. And so addressing that, that's the first thing I'm doing. I'm going in, and I'm finding out what my trainers are like that are really impacting the lives of my members. And then my front desk, too, is extremely important. I think it's one of the most overlooked positions in gyms. A lot of managers kind of just dismiss the minimum wage kid that's working the front desk. But that kid is the first person to say hi to that new potential member that walks in the door. So the way they, I would lead from the front. So as the manager or owner, you would see me up there so they could see the way that I react when a new person walks in the door and how I talk to them and the way I treat them so I could get them to buy in and be the same way. And if you can get your entire team to make every person who walks in that door to feel special, the other stuff will come. Getting smarter as a trainer, getting good nutrition advice, better equipment. I've seen the worst gyms, the way they look aesthetically, with rookie trainers destroy other gyms. In fact, this is something that connected all of us. This is what one of the things I was known for in the space is I would get a club. They would give me a club that was underperforming, and I had 90 days to turn it around, or else I got demoted. And so I'd go into a club and completely turn the culture around, smash goal. They only let me smash goal for about 2 years because then I'm making a lot of money, and then they just make me start over again. Here's another club. And I'd walk in behind somebody else. And the first thing I always do is I observe. So I watch for 30 days and just kind of pay attention to what everybody's doing. And then I get in, get dirty myself, and I start showing everybody how I want them to be inside the facility. And then I start cutting out all the bad apples and then build my team, the people that I want that understand my vision.
Yeah, you know what's a good example of culture is this is the success of CrossFit, really. They kind of prove that, because the CrossFit model, when they started coming up, at that time it was the big boxes were dominating, and they were big, amazing gyms with lots of equipment, lots of amenities, and here are these small garage, you know, facilities with squat racks and bumper plates and chalk, you know, concrete floors. And they were popping up everywhere, and it was because they understood culture. If you go to a CrossFit gym now, probably the reason why you keep going and what drew you there really was the culture. So it's the most important thing in running a gym. And it starts with the staff. It starts with the staff dictates that, then the members start to follow. So.